Want to see something cool? Sure, let's look at OpenRGB then. And what is OpenRGB, you may ask? It's an open source RGB control software. A little like Signal RGB. I know they have sponsored Linus Tech Tips before, but I have tried it. And I think this is even better. No joke, I'm not even kidding. It supports as much devices, like it supports basically all like well recognized peripheral brands and like for PC components and stuff. And they also support things like Nanoleafs, which is pretty nice. I find it really, really cool. So how do we get started? Yeah, we just go to the website openrgb.org and then we download it. And we can scroll down a little here to like see some of the features here. And yes, that is some of the features I find really, really cool. That it, yes, eliminate bloatware, obviously, because you don't need to have all those other programs installed. And lightweight, it is very lightweight. And then it's open source and cross-platform. One thing, Signal RGB isn't. It isn't cross-platform, it's Windows only. The fact that it's open source also means that there is plugins for it. People can go make plugins, which there's one, at least one we need to make this really good. And if you scroll down here, we can download it. There is all these different download things. So what we're gonna do, I'm gonna take the experimental version here because it has some more features. And I have 64-bit system, so I'm taking that. And it downloads here, it downloads as a zip file here. So then you can just open and show in folder, and then we're gonna extract it by right clicking and pressing extract all. So now we have it here, and we have here, and then we have the openrgb.exe here. Now just right click on this and run it as administrator at least first time. That is important, else it can't recognize your devices. Now, because we run it as administrator and it's not a recognized program by Windows, then we need to allow it and say run anyway. So do that. It should pop up on your screen after a few seconds. And you can see here, we already have some devices that popped up. So here you can just like set the things you want to do. If I want to turn all my devices pink, I can just like, I'm on the keyboard now, it just turned pink. Then I can click on apply to all devices. And then boom, everything is pink. Now, I have nano leaves. They're not turned on right now. And wouldn't it be cool if it could sync with everything else? So we're gonna go into settings here. And you can see we have all these different things here. You can also see you can connect Philips Hue devices, Philips Wiz, Yeelight, Nano Leaf, and Elgato Keylight devices. I'm just gonna add a Nano Leaf device here. Now your Nano Leaf needs to be set up and connected to the Wi-Fi you're on. Mine is, then just click scan here. And then you can see we have on the screen right here. Now what you need to do is set it in pairing mode. My Nano Leaf, there's a quick guide at the top how to do it. I'm just gonna do it right now. Then I just need to click pair. And it is paired. And now we can go in here, and this is a little confusing, but now before it shows up, we have to press rescan devices. Also, if you connect a new keyboard or something, you have to press rescan devices, so it scans for the device. So I'm going to press that right now, and boom, do it again. And now you can see I have my Nano Leafs here. So I'm just going to click on the pink there, and whoa, now it's totally pink. And we can do a lot of different stuff. We can mainly here we can set colors and stuff, which isn't, you know, super fun. You know, it's nice to have, but it's not super fun. We want like effects and stuff, right? What we're gonna do is download a plugin called Effects Engine. We just open the website again, and because it's like an official sort of plugin, we can just go to the top and click on the menu button here and click on plugins, and it's gonna take us to a plugin site, and you can see downloaded for your system here. I have Windows 64-bit, so I'm downloading for that. And now Windows says that this file type can be dangerous. Yeah, it's because it's a DLL file that can execute stuff on your computer, but we need it, so I'm gonna press keep it. And then we can go into OpenRGB again, click on settings and plugins, and you can just click install plugin. And then you need to go to your folder where I have it, and right there, that's a DLL file. And yes, Now we have the effects plugin and we can do all sorts of different stuff here. Now I hate lights. I haven't been outside in multiple days, so I'm just gonna set this program to dark mode here and then it needs to be restarted. And when you need to open it again, you just search for here OpenRGB, and you can see down here that OpenRGB.exe comes here. You can just right click it if you want to run it as administrator. And after a few seconds, it takes a few seconds, it pops up again. And you can see it's dark mode now, way nicer. And I have the effects plugin here. So let's see which kind of effects there is. Can never get enough. Never ending circles. Can't get you on my mind. So yeah, that was OpenRGB. Is it cool or not? Let me know in the comments. I think it's really cool, and I think you should go try it because it is that cool. If you have any problems or something, let me know in the comments and I'll try to answer them all. But yeah, that was basically it for this video, and if you want, you can like and subscribe, and see you next time.